Hi, right, so we've got another day, so you know what that means. Another thing being ruined by women. It's always the case. This time it's football. Well, women's football. And there's this story going around. Spain won the World Cup, right? The Women's World Cup, right? But still, for the women's Spanish team, that's the biggest possible trophy that they could ever win, right? So they won the World Cup, and after the World Cup, there were celebrations, and they were going up to get their medals and to lift the trophy, you know. And in doing so, they had to go past all these people, all of whom were shaking their hands, hugging them, kissing them, and so on, right? It was a As I say, it was like the biggest achievement of their lives. Everybody was excited, everybody was happy. It's very similar to what happens in the Men's World Cup, where when it comes to prize time, the losers look dejected, they just want to go home. The winners are celebrating, everybody's hugging, everybody's kissing, everybody's shaking hands, everybody's dancing and having a good time. But you know what it's like, man. I will never understand this about women, but anytime men might get the idea of having fun, women have to destroy that immediately, and it can't have that, right? So as soon as there's fun being had and it's not about them specifically, they have to ruin that fun. So this is what happened in the cup final. Obviously, because it's women's football, I wasn't watching it, right? I don't care about women's football. And I love football. Take from that what you will. Everything was happy. There was no issues. No issues at all. There's a trophy. Everybody go home. Brilliant. Then 3 days later, one of the women, no doubt after she'd been cornered by all the feminists or all the lesbians on the team. I know I just repeated myself there, but once she was cornered by all the lesbians and was told, "Do you know that you're a victim of sexual abuse and sexual harassment?" "When?" "Well, you see, you know when everybody was hugging and kissing you after the World Cup victory?" "You mean when everybody was doing it in the World Cup?" "Yes, I remember that." "Well, there was a guy there and he did it as well. Therefore, he's got a penis. You're a victim of sexual harassment." "Really?" And that's how the story goes. This is a tweet from Fox News here, right? "Kiss and tell. Soccer player kissed by boss after World Cup win breaks her silence as scandal swirls." Breaks her silence means I didn't have any fucking issue with it at the time, and it wasn't until 3 days later where I realized, now that we've got over the World Cup win, I could get some victimhood from this, and I can play the victim, and I can destroy a man's life. I think I'll take that. I'll take that opportunity. And 3 days later, she decides that I felt vulnerable and a victim of an impulsive driven, sexist, out of place act without any consent on my part. You can see right there, it's got all the feminist talking points. Impulsive driven, sexist, out of place, consent. It's just filled with the feminist buzzwords, right? And when you go through the article, this is an article that's from this tweet, right? You click on this is the article that you get, right? Spain's Jenny Hermoso says she felt vulnerable when Luis Rubiales performed non-consensual kiss, because when everybody's hugging and kissing, you're actually supposed to stop and say, I know we're all celebrating here, but is it okay if I hug you in celebration? Is that okay? That's what you're supposed to do, apparently. Only if you're a man, though. But when you look at this article, right, just to quickly scroll through it, you can see here, right? Boom, there's nothing there. There's nothing. It's just photos of her, photo of him, photo of him. But there's no video of the actual ones. I clicked on the video, but I think it's just some bullshit sports headlines. It doesn't actually lead to any video about that incident, you know? Incident. So I as I said in that tweet there that I wrote, I always get suspicious when they say things like this, but they don't show footage, because if I'm on a jury and this is the case, I want to see the video. I want to see the fucking, I want to judge for myself, right? Because, sorry, but I don't automatically believe women when 3 days after an event they just claim that they're a victim. I want to see for myself, are they a victim, right? So, as I say, here is the footage in this article so you can see for yourself. There's nothing in this at all, and everyone is kissing, hugging each other. Women ruin everything, right? Don't worry, I'll show you that video in a second, right? But before I show you the video, right? And amazingly, what shocked me more than anything, it's actually on the BBC. I couldn't fucking believe it. The feminist BBC showed the video, right? Now, I picture it myself. If I walk up to a woman, no consent and no context given, I just go up to a woman, I grab her, I kiss her on the lips, the ones on her mouth, you dirty pervert. I kiss her on the lips, right? The absolute bare fucking minimum that I can expect from that is for her to go, oh, what the fuck are you doing? That's the bare minimum. I mean, it would escalate. There'd be more than that. Oh, she'd probably scream at me. She'd probably hit me. Guys who saw it happen and heard her screaming would probably hit me. The police would probably get involved. I'd probably get arrested. I'd probably be charged with sexual harassment, sexual assault. You know, all of that is going to happen. But the absolute fucking bare minimum is that she would flinch and pull away and go up and say, what the fuck are you doing? What are you doing? Get away from me. What the fuck? That's if it's a non-consensual kiss. Even if it was in a situation where everybody's celebrating, so it's a woman, so I don't know, what do women celebrate? I don't know, let's say she baked a great cake or something, right? I'm kidding, ladies, right? But let's just say, for instance, she baked a great cake and everybody's celebrating this fucking cake. Wow, my God, you just baked the most amazing cake ever. And everybody's hugging her and everybody's, you know, and I go up and I hug her and then I go to kiss her again. If that's not wanted, even in the situation of celebration, she's going to pull away. What the fuck are you doing? That's what's going to happen every single time. So remember, she's in here. I felt vulnerable 3 days later. I felt vulnerable and a victim of impulsive, driven, sexist, out of place act without any consent on my part. Okay, so let's see how she reacted to this kiss then, right? Because obviously, as I say, the bare minimum, she's going to pull away, right? She's going to be horrified. Of course, right? So let's watch, shall we? Let's see. So this is a video here on the BBC. Don't need sound. I've not got the sound on. Don't need sound for it. It's pointless. Just watch this. So that's him there, and that's her, and that's the kiss, right? And you may have seen a lot of screenshots of this, you know? But have you seen the actual video? Let's watch the video, right? And watch, also, watch everybody else as well, and watch how they nicely blur out the people in the background doing the exact same fucking thing, so as to make it appear that it's only him that's doing it, right? It's a horrible tactic that the media do, but just watch. And he goes, look, blur them out. Don't show that. So let's go over that again. Let's check that again, right? So he hugs her, right? There we go. Hug, kiss, right? Kiss, right? Oh, he goes, oh, look. Now you can see there. Look, he's absolutely overjoyed. He's part of this team that's just won the fucking World Cup. And there he's kissing her as well, and he's hugging her because obviously he's a mad pervert. But there she's there. She's walking up and she's kissing the World Cup. Well, I don't watch women's football. I presume that's what the women's World Cup looks like. I don't know. But watch her reaction when he kisses her on the mouth. Right. Just watch her reaction. Right. Watch this. Watch her reaction here. No reaction. No reaction at all. Nothing. She didn't pull away. She didn't look disgusted. She walked away with a fucking smile on her face. Is that what women do when they get sexually harassed? Did she walk away with a smile on her face? Really? You can't go back 3 days later and say, oh, actually, I did feel uncomfortable then. No, you fucking didn't. We've got the video evidence right here. You don't feel uncomfortable at all. You're taking part in the celebrations. Everybody's happy. And look at him as well. He's absolutely overjoyed. He looks like a fucking geek enjoying his favourite thing, his favourite sport. I mean, he's just fucking loving the moment. But because women have this really, really low opinion of men, they're thinking of this as he must have got off on that. He didn't like a pervert. Like, does he look like a guy that's ready to knock one out? I mean, they're acting like he did it, and then immediately, oh, sorry, I fucking shit. I've got a fucking raging hard on now because I'm a mad perv. I need to go to the fucking changing room and knock one out. This is gonna, I'm gonna take someone's eye out with this thing. No, that didn't happen here. It's just, they're just enjoying them. Everybody's enjoying the moment, you know? Everybody's doing it. Hang on a minute. Whoa. Did I see that right? Did you get her consent to hook her? Would be you, bitch. Did you get her consent to hook her? You fucking raging pervert. How dare you hug that woman without her consent? How the fuck in that situation are you supposed to get consent? What the fuck are they talking about? Seriously, what are they talking about? It's absolutely fucking ridiculous, man. But this guy, he's hugging her, he kisses her on the cheek, absolutely loving the moment, doesn't kiss her on the mouth. She's the only one that got it on the mouth, and that's what they're picking on, you know. But this is the kind of thing that happens in the guys' game. But when it happens in the guys' game, they don't make a big deal about it, and they don't say, oh my God, these guys are victims, consent, blah, blah, blah. They don't say any of that. In fact, they write articles celebrating it. Football's most iconic kisses, from Gary Neville's smooch to Diego Maradona's on-pitch snog. So just to quickly go through, football players kissing each other because they've just won in the Manchester Derby, which is a big deal. They've just won, Boca Juniors just won against River Plate, another big deal. What's this one? Rakitic and Kiriko were overjoyed after the Europa League triumph. As you can see, passionate moments, people get carried away. Alonso and Gerrard there. I mean, it goes on. As you can see, it goes on. That one was the funniest one because McCoys did not see that one coming, and it was dead funny at the time. I remember that. That was hilarious. This is all fun and games. It's all like just a big laugh, you know. But as soon as a woman's involved, it's the worst thing ever. And now it's to the point where that man, Rubiales, his mother is on hunger strike, you know. Because as she said here, to scroll down to what the part she says, I just want her to tell the truth and stick to the version she had when all this started. The version, of course, being that there is no sexual contact or anything like that. I mean, going back to that video, where is that video that it's there? Going back to this video, I mean, honestly, right, even in real life and all the movies and soap operas and everything that you've ever seen, have you ever seen a more non-sexual kiss than that? I mean, it's fucking ridiculous. Now, I have a solution to this, right? I think the solution, because people are saying he should resign because a woman cried, claims she's a victim, therefore this man must now lose his job, apparently, for some reason, because that's what men are supposed to do. If a woman cries, we're supposed to just go, right, okay, I resign then, I'll go and work in a factory that just has men in it, because at least then I might be safe from this bullshit. But my solution is simple, right? Let's put it back onto the nice cheerleader, look at her. My solution is simple. I think that men should steer clear as far away as possible from women's football. Don't watch it. Don't talk about it. Don't joke about it. Don't mention it in passing. Don't get involved in any conversation about it. Just act like it doesn't fucking exist. Take nothing to do with it at all. That way, us men can't bother you anymore, you know. So we won't be buying the tickets to your games or anything like that, because we don't want to bother you, you know. Because if I buy a shirt and it's got a woman's name on the back of the shirt, I'm not sure that might be stalking or sexual harassment or something. I don't want to take the chance, so I'll just stick to the men's game. Yeah, that's what I'll do. I will avoid the women's game at all costs, since it's so fucking easy to get accused of the worst crimes when you haven't really done anything wrong, you know. But it's totally part of the game. If you've ever watched football, you know it's part of the game when there's a big victory. And you'd better fucking believe, if Rangers ever win the Champions League, I'll be fucking shagging any guy that's out there. I don't give a fuck. I will be celebrating that shit. So I'll stay clear of women, though, because that'll be sexual. Aye, you just can't do anything. They ruin absolutely everything. We want to be part of this. Can you not just leave? No, we want to be part of it. We want to be part of this game, this football thing that you're enjoying. We want to be part of it. What they really meant was, we want to ruin this because we can see that you're enjoying it. That's what they really meant. Whenever women say we want to be part of that thing, like gaming, for example. Video games, what are those guys doing over there with video games? They seem to be enjoying themselves. We want to be part of this as well. No, nobody's stopping you. Oh my God, gamers are so sexist. Oh, for fuck's sake, man. Why do you always have to just ruin everything? Because everybody knows, especially when you see that video, everybody knows there's nothing in that. Do you really believe that he is some mad, creepy pervert who's thinking to himself, oh, I'm going to fucking kiss her on the lips because I am such a perv, you know? I'm such a fucking pervert. I'm going to kiss her on the lips and then run away and knock one out. There was nothing in it. There was nothing in it. But they have such a low opinion of men, as I said, that they think we're all raging perverts and any contact with women, it will do anything for any contact with women. Well, okay, we'll just stay away from you now. All your pastimes, we won't take part, and you won't get our money or our support or anything like that, since, you know, we don't want to upset you, don't want to bother you, so we'll leave you be. We'll leave you be. Fucking pains in the ass, man. Anyway, thanks very much for listening. Until next time.